Alright everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be about KB Toys. KB was the toy store at the mall. Well, that was their slogan anyway. And it was pretty much true, as about 70% of their locations were located inside of shopping malls. There were a few freestanding locations, but that wasn't really their MO. So if you're not familiar with this store, it's not the one with Jeffrey the Giraffe. That's Toys R Us. But don't worry, they didn't fare so well either. I'll be doing a video about them here soon. So KB had a different business model as a toy store than most. I would compare it to an Ollie's or a Big Lots nowadays. It was kind of like a surplus overstock store. Here, I'll give you an example about that. Say it's the holiday of 1996 and you're looking for the hottest toy to give as a gift. Alright, bear with me here if you were born in the 2000s, because this really did happen. So that year, the most popular gift was Tickle Me Elmo. Yeah, it was Elmo. Anyways, KB wouldn't be the place to buy it that year. They would either be sold out or they wouldn't have even stocked it. They probably just would have waited until the following year to have it in stock when it was less in demand and the price was cheaper. And in return, they sold it for a lower price. Makes sense. So anyways, that's pretty much how they did things. And during their peak, they would have about 1,200 stores. As I said, most of them were located inside malls. They would go on to change ownership several times throughout their existence. I mean, they had their ups and downs. But it was a little surprising when it all came to a grinding halt in December of 2008. So this story starts back in 1922, when Harry and Joseph Kaufman opened a wholesale candy company. Their business model was buying in bulk and selling candy to smaller stores. It would be located in Pittsfield, Massachusetts. So selling candy was their core business. That is, until 1940. That year they would acquire a wholesale toy company. It was said they received the toy company as a payment for a debt. I mean, that whole situation sounds kind of odd, but it did propel them into the toy business. The first storefront wouldn't be open until 1946. It was called KB Toy and Hobby. The name was their initials, the Kaufman Brothers, hence KB. I mean, all that makes sense, but what I can't figure out is the way they spelled it. They spelled KB out, as in K-A-Y-B-E-E. Yeah, I don't get it either. But anyways, this store was also located in Pittsfield. So with the launch of that new store, it was pretty much a success right away. They decided to ditch the candy business, and they went 100% into toys. So fast forward to 1973, KB Toys enters the mall scene. Malls were just starting to become a thing. It was the latest and greatest, so they jumped on the opportunity to have a store there. So with that said, just 1 year later, they would expand to 26 retail stores, all of them located within shopping malls. 5 years later, in 1979, their store count would be 40. Just a few years later, in 1981, they would experience massive growth. They would now have 210 stores. However, this would be the same year that the company was sold. The buyer was Melville Corporation. The price, $64 million. Now, you've probably never heard of Melville, neither have I, but I'm sure you're familiar with the company they own. They were actually the owners of CVS Pharmacy. In 1983, Melville would buy California-based company Toy World for $5.5 million, and they would convert 37 of their stores into KB Toys. Then, 7 years later, in 1990, they would buy Circus World for $95 million. This would add 330 new stores in 30 states. So around this time is when they started using that slogan. They were the toy store at the mall. That's how they wanted to be known. 1 year later, in 1991, they would buy K&K Toys. That would add an additional 136 stores. So at this point, the company is expanding fairly quickly, mostly from acquisitions, but nonetheless, they might be growing too quick. So during the mid-1990s, competition was getting pretty intense in the toy market. Most notably from Toys R Us, Walmart, and Target. I mean, not to mention foot traffic within shopping malls was starting to decline. So, KB decided to shift their store model a little bit. they would start to shift their focus away from the overstock slash surplus model, and they would start to open new stores, this time focusing more on the latest and greatest toys. Their new store concept would be called KB Toy Works. These stores were much larger, and would mostly be freestanding. They were starting to get away from the mall scene a little bit. In 1995, they would report over $1 billion in sales. That's billions with a B. However, they would close 250 of their less performing stores. Then just 1 year later, they would be sold to Consolidated Stores Corporation for a reported $315 million. This is the same company that owned Big Lots and Odd Lots, so it just made sense adding KB Toys. Consolidated didn't waste any time. They got to work right away. First off, they would change the brand name from the spelling KB to the initials KB, which I thought they should have to begin with. Anyways, they also launched a new website, and it seemed to be a hit right away. In 1996, they would reach their max. That's $1.6 billion in sales that year. Alright, so 1 year later, in 1997, their store count was now at 1,324. During this time, they would invest a massive $80 million into their website. They would also partner with AOL to advertise on their homepage. This deal was estimated around $40 million. All this sounds good, but in the year 2000, it was reported that sales were quickly declining. They stated the money they invested into their website, it wasn't paying off. Along with that, a 20% loss in video game sales that year. So with all that being said, they announced they'd be looking for a buyer. So enter Bain Capital. They would take over operations of KB Toys via a leveraged buyout. So I'm definitely not an expert in the stock market, but I know these leveraged buyouts usually don't work out too well. Here's what Google had to say about it. It's the purchase of a controlling share in a company by its management using outside capital. So yeah, I can tell you that the company will pretty much always be in debt, as the money they used to buy it was probably borrowed. So anyways, that happened, and now KB Toys is privately owned. So I found this to be interesting. In 2001, they would open small toy and electronic stores inside of Sears. I mean, I just don't know how that worked out, because didn't Sears already have an electronics and a toy department? So yeah, if you remember this, let me know about it in the comments. And also, if you're enjoying this video, please give it a thumbs up. It helps me out way more than you probably know. Anyways, in 2003, Bain Capital dumped nearly $85 million more in debt on the KB Toys. So at this point, their total debt was estimated around $300 million. And I can tell you, the holiday shopping season didn't do them any favors that year. So in early 2004, they announced they would be filing for Chapter 11 bankruptcy protection. This would close about 600 stores and lay off 3,400 employees. 1 year later, in 2005, they would have a legal battle with both Hasbro and Lego. Well, that's not a good sign, as those are two of the largest toy manufacturers. However, later in 2005, they would actually exit Chapter 11, and they were looking for a buyer. This time, the buyer would be Prentice Capital Management. They would invest around $20 million into the stores. However, it must not have did too much for them, because they would announce just 2 years later that they would close another 122 stores. So things are starting to look really bad at this point, and they would go on to make one last-ditch effort to try to recoup some of their costs. They would offer over 200 toys at a price of $10 or less. I mean, that sounds like a pretty good deal. That sounds pretty desperate, actually. It must not have done any good, as they would report a loss that holiday season. So the announcement was made that they would close and liquidate all their remaining stores by February 2009. And later in 2009, all remaining assets would be sold to Toys R Us.
Mayhem has been around for about 20 years. The store closing signs are drawing in families looking to stretch their Christmas money. With sales 30 to 50% off, the bargains are being swept off store shelves. In addition to this store here in Kalihi, the sale signs have also gone up at Pearl Ridge and Ala Moana. The company had been looking to liquidate more than 100 stores across the country. The closing was a
So there is some more to this. The KB Toys name would be sold a few times, and announcements will be made here and there. But years later, nothing really happened. So I didn't include any history after 2009. But if something does happen, I will make an update video. If KB Toys ever does resurface, I will be sure to let you guys know. Anyways, that's all I have for today's video. My voice is now shot, so please like, comment, subscribe, whatever you feel like you want to do. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you next time.